Hello children, good afternoon to one and all. Welcome to the today's session. So please maintain your health, and if you are going outside, wear your mask, go with sanitizer, and be aware of coronavirus, and be safe and be healthy. Okay, so in the last class we have learnt about a lot of things about seasons, what kind of seasons will be affected in our country, about advancing monsoon season we have learnt in the last class. So in today's class we are going to learn about retreating monsoon. Okay, retreating means withdrawal of monsoon season, or post monsoon season we can tell, or a transition season we can give another name for that one. So this retreating take place in the month of October to November. In this month only we will see a transition, that is some changes in the atmospheric condition. Why this retreating monsoon will happen means the sun, it start moving towards the southern part, so that is why as well as move towards the south, so that is why we will see a low pressure area will be created in the northern plain, and whatever winds are been blowing, which will causes for heavy rainfall as well as which causes for rainfall, that will become very weak. Okay, so the southwest monsoon winds will start weakening and start withdrawing gradually, so during this period. So by the beginning of the month of October, the monsoon withdraws from the northern plain. It starts from the northern plain area, it start withdrawing it. And the month of October and November, from a period of transition from hot rainy season to dry winter season. We will see that transition from rainy season to the dry winter season. So during that time, the sky will be very clear, the temperature will be very high, and humidity will be there. We will tell it is too much hot, we are feeling like a summer season. Okay, like that the temperature will causes very high during the month of October. So commonly that period we call it as a October heat, because of retreating there. So the low pressure condition over the northwest India get transferred to the Bay of Bengal by the early November. In the month of November we will see that transformation from, and it creates the low pressure condition in the northwest India. So this shift is associated with the occurrence of cyclonic depression. So due to that shift as well as due to that transfer, we will see the occurrence of cyclonic effects, which originates over Andaman Sea, where Andaman and Nicobar Island is there. There one Andaman Sea is there. So there that cyclonic effects will be originates there. So these cyclonic generally crosses the eastern coast of India and causes very heavy rainfall in some parts, wherever the coastal area, wherever river are been flowing. So these thickly populated deltas where some rivers are flowing, like Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, are frequently struck by the cyclonic effect, and it causes very damage to the life and the property of the people. Damages a life of the people as well as the property of the people there. So these cyclones arrived at the coast of Orissa. These cyclonic effects will causes as well as if effects in the Orissa rivers in that coastal area. So the West Bengal as well as the Bangladesh. Even these areas also are being affected by the cyclonic effect there. So sometime in the news channels you will hear that during this month some parts of our states in our country, they are receiving very heavy rainfall, and it is caused by the cyclonic effect. one name they will give for every cyclonic effect there. So they will tell frequently that this cyclone this cyclonic effect has been caused a great damage to the life of the people as well as the property there. So in the Orissa, West Bengal, Bangladesh, in these areas you will see it receives very heavy rainfall and it will affected by the flood effects. So the bulk of rainfall of Coromandel coast is derived from the depression and cyclone. Even the Coromandel coast is also affected by the cyclonic effect. Okay, with the help of map I am going to show how it will be created. Okay, you can see a map here. Okay, so in this map you can see the retreating monsoon there. Okay, it is retreating here, it is taking back, it is withdrawing the monsoon season. So in the Bay of Bengal and in the Arabian Sea, here the Andaman and Nicobar Island, in this area we will see a cyclonic depression, a cyclonic effects will be originate and it will affect to the Orissa, here West Bengal and the Bangladesh. And here also some parts, they will tell that in some parts of Western Ghats where the coastal area is there, Western coastal line, even that part is also affected by some cyclonic effect and it is receiving very heavy rainfall during that time. So due to the retreating, when the monsoon start withdrawing it, it creates some cyclonic effect and it causes for heavy rainfall, and that heavy rainfall it turned towards the flood, the drought, etc. there. So due to the retreating. Then what is the distribution of rainfall? Rainfall will happen. So in which area, in which state we will see more rainfall and in which states we will see very less rainfall there. Whether the distribution of rainfall is equally in our country? No, children. No. The distribution of rainfall we will see lot of variation. In one area if it is receiving very heavy rainfall, means in another area it is receiving very low rainfall. Okay, with the help of map I am going to show. You can see a two map here, one is seasonal rainfall and second one is the annual rainfall. So we will discuss about annual rainfall there. So in the northeastern part of our country, this is the northeast part. So this part it receives very heavy rainfall, nearly 400 centimeter rainfall will happen there. So here only the Mohsin Drum, the place Mohsin Drum is there where it is receiving very highest rainfall in the world. If you calculate, means, so where it is receiving very less rainfall, means the part of western part of our country, that is Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab and Haryana. Okay, you can see here it is receiving, it is in light color. Okay, this light color only indicates that this part of area it is receiving very less rainfall. Okay, here you can see it is in a dark blue and little bit purple color is there. So here we will see much rainfall is received, and in the western part of our country, that in Rajasthan, Gujarat, Punjab and Haryana, these parts it receives very less rainfall, like 60 centimeter rainfall it will be happen. So rainfall is equally low in the interior Deccan Plateau, so this region. Okay, you can see this part it receives very low rainfall. And east of Sahyadri, here some Sahyadri mountains have been there, Sahyadris have been there, it receives very less rainfall. And in one place called Jammu and Kashmir, here, yeah, this part of Jammu and Kashmir, it receives very low rainfall, low precipitation. That place we call it as a lay. The rest of the country receives moderate, not much heavy and not much low, a moderate kind of rainfall will be happen in the rest part of our country. So in this way the distribution of rainfall is there in our country. So owning the nature of the monsoon, the annual rainfall is very high, variable from year to year. We will see year to year lot of changes in the weather condition. So variability is very high in the regions of low rainfall. wherever it is receiving very less rainfall. Okay, here you can see it is receiving some areas it is receiving very less rainfall. So this variability of high in the region of low rainfall, such as the parts of Rajasthan, Gujarat, and some parts of Western Ghats, that kind of changes we will see where it is receiving very low rainfall there. So this is the distribution of rainfall. I hope you have understood about retreating monsoon, how the rainfall has been distributed, and in which part it receives very heavy and in which parts it receives very low rainfall, you have came to know. So last but not least, monsoon, it is an unifying bond. Unifying means it is uniting the people, those are living in our country. In what way? How you will justify that monsoon as a unifying bond? If I ask a question in a examination, what kind of answer you have to write? So this is the answer. So you have already learned that Himalayan ranges as well as Himalayan mountains are protecting us. Okay, they are protecting us. Uniform higher temperature when it is compared to the other area in the same latitude. So these cold winds, these too much cold winds are protecting us. Okay, Himalayas protect the subcontinent of our country, and we will receive very higher temperature comparing to the other latitude. So the peninsular plateau is very under the influence of sea, which is covered by the three sides, and it is having a moderating influence and great variations in the temperature conditions. We will see some changes in the Deccan Plateau as well as peninsular region. So this unifying influence of monsoon on subcontinent is quite precipitable. The uncertainties of rain, uneven distribution are very much typical of monsoon, Indian landscape, animals as well as plant life. So due to the uneven distribution of these monsoon season, we will see some changes in the landscape, in the land formation, the life of the people, the life of the animals, as well as the life of the plants. And its entire agricultural calendar and the life of the people, including the festives, that is festival season, revolve around this phenomena only. Okay, it is unifying us. It is having some changes. Okay, you have already known the way that Himalayan protect the subcontinent from extreme cold winds from Central Asia. So this enables northern India to have uniformly higher temperature when compared to the other areas on the same latitude. Similarly, the peninsular plateau is great under the influence of sea, which is covered by the three sides and has a moderate kind of temperature there. Despite such moderating influences, there is a great variation in the temperature condition also in the plateau region. So unifying influence of the monsoon on the subcontinent is quite favorable to the people. So these monsoon winds will bring lot of changes in the people life, in the animal life, in the plant life, and the agricultural calendar, agricultural activities, we will see some changes there. Even our festival will also revolve around this monsoon type of climatic condition only. So these monsoon winds bind the whole country. It will unite the whole country by providing water to set agricultural activities in a motion, as well as to do some activities according to the season. And the river valleys which is carry this water also unite as a single river valley in our country. So monsoon is creating an unifying bond, that is, it is unifying and it is having a unique feature which influences in the life of the people, in their activities as well as in their festival. According to that one only, that festivals are being made. Okay, so in this way, monsoon, it is an unifying bond and it is unifying us as a whole country. So this is all about the climatic condition which is there in our country, which will be affected by the monsoon type of climate, and what are the changes will be happen. So these are all things about climate in our country. So thank you. Thank you once again. If you are having any kind of doubt, just pin your question in the group so that I will try my level best to sort out your problem. Signing out. Have a great day, children. Bye, everyone.